Understand, dear ones, that life is much like a video game. In fact, the video gaming experience is being developed by human beings to replicate this physical experience. If we look back at the history of video gaming development, we will see at first simple pixelated images and very electronic, simplistic tones of sound. And now we move into new generations of creative expression in which the graphics become more real, in which we create brand new worlds and brand new environments, in which we experience a new version of virtual reality that is more exact. It can be said that our dreams are being broadcast in these video game creations. We are putting the images we see in our mind into these electronic art forms, and we are making it available for others to experience our own fantasies and inner realities. The video game world, dear one, is a beautiful expression of creation in which we allow ourselves to step out of this human life and into something different. Recognize, dear one, that there is no judgment of good or of bad, for in reality you are an eternal spirit, and you can explore any aspects of creation. The source consciousness, that which is called God by beings upon this earth, the source consciousness has created it all for you. Every possibility for you to explore. Outside of this earth, dear ones, there are many dimensions, different bodies, different planets, different ways of communicating, different ways of traveling, different inventions, different explorations. There is so much available to you, dear ones, as souls within this universe, and you are free to choose any of it at all. The reasons, dear one, why some of you have attractions to the video gaming reality may include a boredom with the material world because it offers you limited experiences. But what we say, dear one, is that you yourself can expand yourself. You can expand your ability to perceive this world. You, dear ones, can make it so that your eyes see more colors. You can make it so that your emotions have greater depth and expansion of feeling. You can build your physical bodies up to experience great feats of strength. Anything, dear one, anything that you can imagine in this mind, body, and emotion system can be made possible for you. Some realities can be made in the physical and some cannot, simply because of the laws governing the physical reality. But if you would learn, dear one, to harness the power of your mind, you could create lucid dreaming experiences in which you manufacture any reality. And we guarantee you that the fullness of your lucid dreaming experience cannot be matched even by the greatest of virtual reality video gaming systems. The lucid dream, dear one, is that in which you create your own dreaming world, in which you influence and can control all that happens. It is like creating a video game story within your own mind, in which you perceive yourself fully existing within it. It is the greatest experience of virtual reality ever known to man, and often our video gaming systems are trying to replicate this deep, subconscious, and consciously guided experience. And so, dear ones, many of you are attracted to the video gaming reality because you have boredom with the physical world. Often the job experiences, the materialistic identity, the strong attachment to money and ownership, to finances, to greed, to power, to control, to self-image. Often all of these are unattractive to you because they are old systems developed by beings who existed before you incarnated here. There is a new wave of consciousness growing within this world, and you are one with it. But if you, dear ones, hold back your creative expression, if you stay in personal isolation, living out your reality in a video gaming society, and not expressing yourself in the material world, then, dear ones, you are not guiding this world to change its ways. We understand that many of you are not hiding from the world in your video gaming life, but rather many of you simply lack an attraction to interacting in the physical world in greater depth. There is no pull. There is no inner desire. And this is perfectly all right. This is acceptable, dear ones, for we are not judging you to be different. We are not encouraging you to enter into the man-made systems if they are not attractive. But what we are saying is that you should look within your hearts, and you should see what is available to you in this world. You, dear ones, can interact with another human being in such great depth. You have a mental body, an emotional body, and a physical body. And if the world is not attractive, then we say expand your abilities of perception in your mind and in your emotions. You are not feeling the depth of your emotional self. For when you feel the expanded states of emotional energy, you will realize that the video gaming world can do very little to replicate this within yourself. There are emotional energies being created by other humans, being expressed into you, and you create these as well. And so when you work, dear one, with another human being, it is a person-to-person exchange. When you work with an artificial system of intelligence, it cannot generate genuine emotion. The artificial system of intelligence can create physical stimulus through light and sound, and in the future through vibrational feeling. And this will create within you a reaction to that artificial stimulus. But that is not the same as receiving true, life-affirming emotion from another human being. We understand that many of you have grown in homes in which the vibration of emotion expressed by your parents and family members was often that of anger and fear and confusion and sadness. And so you, as souls, have learned to turn off your sensitivity to these emotions, to tune out of your homing environment, and to tune into the artificial realities that video games have presented. And so for many of you, the video games served as a form of medicine, as a form of psychological therapy, allowing you to step out of an environment of suffering and into an environment of peace, into an environment that offered you new challenge. Maybe it was an environment that received you better, for your family did not listen, they did not communicate with you, and in the video gaming world you could communicate with the computer. It would receive your ideas, it would receive your feedback, and it would respond directly to you.